So without further ado, I'm going to turn this over to Mrs. Case, who's going to show off our wonderful choir.
Thank you.
spirit when I hear them sing. So let's give them another big round of applause. The best of things this morning. We may need to zoom up just a little bit and allow them to come in. You guys here in the back, just a tiny bit, front row. Come on up just a little bit. We'll let them through there. I know it's hard to get through. We'll squeeze you in wherever we can. Okay. Well, we'll go ahead and get started with the next portion of our show. You guys did something right after we came back from Thanksgiving. And you guys were amazing at this. And that is, we talk as a school about making a positive impact on our world. That's our mission statement, is that Fairbrook students are taught that we can make a positive impact all over our world. And you did that in the first couple of weeks of December. And so we have Mrs. Larrabee and Mrs. Gilly here, who are gonna talk about that impact that you had on our community. So without any further ado, I'm gonna turn it over to Mrs. Larrabee, and she's gonna talk about Links of Love.
Our service club here at Fairbrook gave a lot of hours to help raise that money by selling Links of Love. We also, in November, did our Epilepsy Awareness Month and raised money there. And I'll talk about that in a little bit. But Links of Love has been a part of Fairbrook. Well, I've been here 15 years, and it was years and years before that. So, and we've always given it to two organizations that we feel can make a difference. So this year we're giving it to FISH, and they'll talk about that in a minute, and also to the Epilepsy Foundation. So we raised a total of $2,057.28 in Links of Love. Totals to show what each class raised. Okay, sorry. Mrs. Hofler's class raised 125 links. Mrs. Kosick's class raised 182 links. Mrs. Moore and Mrs. Patko's class raised 480 links. Ms. Young's class raised 280 links. Ms. Deddy's class raised 212 links. Mrs. Ferguson's class raised 240 links. And Mrs. Schultz's class in first grade raised 280 links. And Mrs. Timmerman raised 340 links. Mrs. Lamb's class raised 650 links. Mrs. Newman's class raised 675 links. Mrs. Wicksander's class raised 448 links. Mrs. Brenner's class raised 230 links. Mrs. Laumslager's class raised 263 links. Mrs. Renner's class raised 401 links. Mrs. Shadle's class raised 345 links. In fourth grade, Mrs. Quarter's class raised 749 links. Mrs. Mayer raised 834 links. Ms. Bartlett's class raised 466 links. Mrs. Franz's class raised 775 links. Mr. Miller's class raised 675 links. And our winning classroom is, drum roll please, 1,525 links for Mrs. Thompson's class. I need a zero-inch voice, please. I'll wait for quiet. So with that money of $2,057.28, and every link counted, so if you only bought one link for 25 cents or bought 100 links for $20, each one of those links matter. But we're going to split the checks. We're going to have Mrs. Dice come up first. She's from the Fish Pantry here in Beaver Creek, and she's just going to talk for a minute about what that money will do for Fish Pantry.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. It's wonderful to see you. Each year I watch you grow a little older, and I guess I'm getting a little older. But you have helped Fish for so many years. And we actually, this year, the pantry has grown so, 700, as of the end of November, 732 bags of food have gone out to families in Beaver Creek. Last night, I had a call from a family with four children, and they've been without water for 3 days. Now, I know at this age, baths don't mean a whole lot, right? You really play. But when you become teenagers, that's when your parents have to put a limit on how long you stay in the shower. But can you imagine going 3 days, not having water to use, not being able to do laundry, which of course that pleases your moms, I'm sure, not having water to drink, not having actually to use the bathroom in any way. I mean, that can be a real problem, right? That's where, you know, Christmas is about love. Love came to us. You people have given love every day of the year because we use this money all year round to go out to families in Beaver Creek. So even though I know you look forward to receiving your gifts, you have given a wonderful, wonderful great gift to people in Beaver Creek. So I thank you, and I'm really very, very honored to be able to be here to receive this.
Thank you so much. And next I'm going to call up Mrs. Jax. Mrs. Jax is from the Epilepsy Foundation, and we're actually going to give her two checks, and I'll explain why in a second. But the first one is for Links of Love, so they're also getting $1,028.64 for all the things you did with Links of Love. And then the second check the Epilepsy Foundation is receiving is from our November fundraiser. You guys remember where when you paid a dollar to bring a stuffed animal in, and you brought a dollar in to wear your pajamas, and you brought a dollar in to wear a hat? And we learned some facts about epilepsy, and we are uplifting epilepsy this whole year. So, but we mainly chose the month of November since it was National Epilepsy Awareness Month to raise our money. So, and our service club also did a bake sale at our math night where they raised $184, which is included in this. But we have a second check for $1,298.60 to go to the Epilepsy Foundation of Ohio because of the money you raised by doing all those different things, bringing in those dollars.
Wow, thank you all. Can we clap for you? What a great job to raise so much money for causes in the community. And epilepsy is really important, so we really, really appreciate everything that you did to raise this money, because we're trying to help people understand that epilepsy is a disease like any other, And a lot of kids have epilepsy, which is something we're not real happy about. We're trying to figure out how to come up with ways to treat and cure it. But also, kids who have epilepsy and the people who love them need help too. So we help provide camperships, so kids with epilepsy can go to a special camp and be able to hike and have a great time at camp like any other kid. We have a kids program called Kids Crew, where kids can sign up and you get little pins and you do things and you earn more pins. And we're going to have Free Kings Island for Kids Crew kids this year, and we're going to do all kinds of fun stuff. And we also do programs in the school where we try to teach people about epilepsy and seizures and what to do if somebody they see having a seizure, and try to help kids understand more about epilepsy, because unfortunately, a lot of kids who have epilepsy get bullied in school. We want to make sure that doesn't happen, because people who have epilepsy need help from the kids who are around them. They need kids to understand that it's something they when they have a seizure, they need you to help keep them safe, and to tell a teacher if you see something happen, and to help the teachers keep the kids safe as well. So I cannot tell you how much we appreciate the money that you raised for us, and how much I appreciate all the work that you did for all the people in Ohio who have epilepsy by donating this. Thank you very, very much. Generosity and everything that you did to help us give this much money to these two very worthy foundations. So thank you so much, Mrs. Jacks, for coming in too. Alrighty. Well, now we have one of our very special surprises for our teachers and our staff here at Fairbrook would like to give you as part of their holiday wishes for you. So teachers, if you'd like to come on up and take your places.
Thank you.
favorite part of the holiday assembly that we do. So if I could have all of our students who are in fifth grade that are going to be doing the reading or lighting of the candle, could you please stand up and come on up to the front? Fifth grade. Alrighty. Okay, we'll go ahead and get started. So this is Miss Bartlett's class, and it is their class wish. And then whoever's going to be lighting the candle will be able to get the clarity. Okay, you want to go ahead and
Miss Bartlett's class holiday wish is that all military families are together this holiday season.
Mrs. Timmerman's class.
Mrs. Timmerman's class wishes that everyone will be kind to one another and we all have a Merry Christmas.
Mrs. Jenny's class.
Mrs. Jenny's class wishes that everyone would be safe and kind to one another.
Our classroom Christmas wish is for everyone to be happy and healthy.
Okay, this is Ms. Young's class.
We wish for everyone to have a safe and merry Christmas.
Thank you. Very nice. Ms. Thompson's class.
We wish that everyone will be kind to one another.
Mrs. Hoefler.
We wish that everybody would be safe and be kind.
Ms. Packer.
We wish for everyone to be happy.
Very nice. Thank you very much. So everybody did a very nice wish. I heard lots of things about being kind to one another, and that was awesome. That goes along with what we hope to accomplish this year, which is spreading kindness like confetti, right? So very nice. I liked hearing that. I loved all those holiday wishes. I hope that all of them come true. Well, at this time, I think we might have somebody special that visits us on this time. So those will be brought to your teachers, and I'm sure Santa will be around just a little bit this morning so that you all can see him again. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and wrap up our holiday assembly. You guys have been a great audience. We need to have a great exit. I'd like to start with our kindergarten.